Hi everyone. Today we are looking at the second module, session 1 for standard 6. The chapter is Combustible Material and Fire Extinguishers. Chapter 12 of the Karnataka State Syllabus. The session is divided into the opening, the main creation and the closure. We start the opening by asking the children if they have seen fire stations. Explain that a fire station is a place where people have equipment and necessary skills to go fight and stop a fire. Then tell them that the fire brigade chief in their fire station had reached out to the teacher saying that there is a shortage of firefighters in that area. And because we want people to do the training and learn how to be firefighters, they have come to the school, and for the next 3 weeks, we are going to learn everything about fire and we'll get a small certificate saying that we understand what fire is and how to stop them. So, we'll start the lesson telling them this and getting them excited about learning about fire. Now we go into the main creation. We ask the children if they've seen a fire and tell them that fire is seen when you burn something, and that is combustion. Combustion is basically burning of any substance. And you put up the card which says the word combustion so that they can read it. Then you ask the students, what do you see, hear or smell or feel when a fire burns? Let children share their answer, and then you can tell them that when a fire burns, heat, light and smoke are produced. You feel the heat, you can see the light and you can smell the smoke. After that, you ask them what are the kind of things that you've seen catch fire. Let them share their answers like wood, paper, etc. And then you tell them that any substance which can catch fire is called a combustible substance. Then you split the class into small groups of 6 and give each of them this worksheet which they need to fill. Now the worksheet has on top a number of words of combustible substances which can catch fire and some which cannot catch fire. Then below that is 3 columns. The first column says that highly combustible substances, which means substances that can catch fire very quickly. The middle one is ordinary combustible substances. They are substances which catch fire but not as quickly as highly combustible substances. And the last column is substances which cannot catch fire. Some of the examples that are given here are rock, water which cannot catch fire. There's petrol, diesel, dry wood which are highly combustible substances. And there is plastic, cloth which are ordinary combustible substances. After the group fills in this worksheet as a group, the group will share the answer with you and you can have a discussion with the rest of the whole class to see what is the right answer for this. Then we move on to the next part of the main creation. Now you start this by an introduction into what you're going to learn. Then you play a game in 2 levels. Now what you're going to learn is what are the things needed to start a fire. So you ask the children, when you see combustion, what are the few things that you need? So let them share their answers and then you break it down into 3 things. We say and put up this card on the board and say that for combustion we need an ignition source, we need combustible material which is the combustible substance, and we need an oxygen source. Ignition source means anything that gives the fire. When you start a fire with a matchstick, you strike the match against the rough area, and that striking action will cause the heat to be produced. And then the end of a matchstick has the combustible material which catches fire very quickly. And you also need the air for it to catch fire. That is basically the 3 things that you need to start a fire. Now you ask them, how can you stop the fire? There are 3 ways of stopping a fire. Put up this card and talk to them about it. Removing out the burning fuel from the spot. For example, if you put oil and catches fire, if you remove the oil, the fire will be stopped. Now how to remove oil is the thing we need to discuss later. cutting off the oxygen supply. When there's a big fire, when there's a small fire, if you stamp on it, what's happening is you also cut off the oxygen supply, or you throw a blanket on it, you're cutting off the oxygen supply, and that's how cutting off oxygen supply will stop a fire. The other thing is cooling down the burning material. When things catch on fire, you also pour water. What water does is it cools down the burning material. So we talk to the children about what are those things that can stop fire quickly. There's sand, there's water, there is a throwing a blanket, and let the children share other ideas which they know of that can be added to the list of things that can stop a fire. Once we finish this initial discussion, we go play the game called Light It Up. Now, Light It Up has cards which are similar to the island cards. There are four types of cards. There is the air source card, which has a cloud drawn on it. There is the material card, which on the corner has three lines drawn. There is the ignition source card, which will have a squiggly spark drawn on it. And there is a card with crosses on it, which acts like the extinguishers. There are two levels to this game. The first level is, you give each group the set of deck of cards. They do not use the X cards, they use all the other cards to play this game. You deal the cards with every children such that everybody gets equal amount of cards. The first child needs to put down a card, and the next child also needs to put down a card. Every child gets a turn to put down a card. Now, with every time you put down a card and make a group of cards come together to make a fire, you will get to mark that and get a score for the fire that you made. For example, there is oxygen, paint, and spark. They three need to come together like this for it to become a proper fire. Okay? They cannot be 1, 2, 3 like this, because then it means that they are not in touch with each other. But they three need to come together like this. After I put the third card, I'll get a point for the fire that I created. Now, I have another card which, if I put in between these two cards, I can make a new fire. Like that, the children need to complete the island and make as many fires as possible. And for every fire they make, they get a marker or a coin which will count as their points. Once they finish that activity, we go on to the next round of the game, the level 2 of the game. For level 2, you need to deal out those cards which has X's on it to each player. Now, the different type of X's would be, like we decided, extinguishers. There is sand, there is water, there is blanket, etc. Now, sand is the kind of extinguisher which can stop a fire by stopping the oxygen. So you need to discuss that in the initial part, saying that what does sand do? Does it kill out? Does it cool down the material, or cut the oxygen, or remove the combustible material? Once you have that discussion, they'll know where exactly to put this. So let the children put the sand in the right place. If it is oxygen, they need to put it on top of oxygen, and they get to stop that fire. Everybody takes turn. Now, like in an ordinary island game, in this game too, after placing every card, they'll have to explain, or after making every fire especially, and after extinguishing any fire, they have to explain how that works. Without that, the other teammates can stop them from getting the markers. Once this game is played a few rounds, the children will learn how to start a fire and stop a fire, and learn about combustible materials and extinguishers. Then we go on to the next part of the main creation, where we will discuss about fire extinguishers. Ask the students if they have seen any fire which cannot be extinguished by just sand or water. Ask them what will happen if there is a fire made by petrol or an electrical fire. What happens is, if you pour water on an electrical fire, is the water gets conducted And if you touch that water, you will get an electric shock. And the people who are trying to extinguish the fire tends to die in such cases. So, big fires which are caused by oil, petrol, LPG, electricity, etc. can be extinguished only by special resources which are called fire extinguishers. Fire extinguisher is a device which can protect us by extinguishing fires. Once that is done, that discussion is done, we move on to the closure. In the closure, you introduce to them the at-home activity. The at-home activity is a worksheet which asks them to draw or write all the uses of fire in their daily life. Show them the handout and explain it to them so that they can do it at home later, and ask them to bring it back in the next session. With that, the session is done. Thank you so much. See you in the next session.